Hello everyone, Richard back for more Panzer Corps Ultimate Mode Grand Campaign West 4243. We are at South Etna Line. For this map, my plan is to build a small defensive line here and hold this for as long as possible. And then once the artillery support gets here, I do a retreat, and there's some exit hexes I might get to. And then I'll have a pretty strong position here. And a minor victory is hold two objectives. I actually managed to hold three. That decisive is hold like all but one, and there's just no way for me to do that. For a long time, I can hold this, but I can't break out really because there's just too much stuff. So let's just let it run and you'll see what it did. Yeah. I did get some decent experience on several key units. I brought all three level bombers. I don't remember if I brought all three level bombers. Two level bombers, okay. Ahead of time, I spot the artillery that has to go down, so that way my units can entrench safely. I bring my anti-aircraft this way. Look at all of that bullshit. There's like eight planes in that first wave. That is a lot. And I only have four fighters. Four fighters for eight planes. So then I finish off the artillery, and that makes this position secure. Just like that. And I'm bringing Tigers to come late. I don't need the Tigers right away. I need to get all the other units in position first. And then for some reason, this plane attacked my 12.8 gun. That was weird. I guess that was the most promising target. That's why I'm entrenching, so I can increase my chances for a rugged defense. Okay, the fighters are gone. So, a strategy I use is I keep weak units in front, so I have time to clean up the edges if necessary. They're finally approaching over there. Those are conscripts I have in the city. And they've been entrenching this whole time. Yeah, they didn't. That tank didn't attack my Stug. That was nice. The Stugs do have really high ground defense. So I've built my cocoon. So the first wave of planes is dealt with. These Tiger tanks are nice. It's you have to have Tiger tanks so they don't attack you without artillery support. This is why level bombers are nice. You get that extra suppression. Those tigers are nasty. As you can see, I'm basically out of prestige because I had to upgrade my tanks to tigers. But that's what allowed me to hold myself together. So the enemy has scouts in front, and that's preventing them from making much progress. And now let's see if my entrenchment plan works. Probably. At least for a while. Now you have really weak paratroopers. You saw those one star conscripts dealt a lot of damage to paratroopers. You don't see that too often. And I have weak units in front that protect me. Overstrength loss on the Stug is not a big deal. It needed to happen anyway. I see an opportunity to try to kill a cons. Look at that. Those conscripts did great. Meanwhile, my Crotchetson's really entrenched, so that should help him if he gets attacked again. Second attack wave starts. Now the artillery's coming, so that's why I have to start abandoning the position. And obviously my conscripts are about to get ripped. They're still holding out, but they don't have much life left in them. Who would have thought that a 15 strength 1-star conscript could hold back an entire division with a 2-star 10 centimeter gun as backup? Man, these level bombers are a lifesaver. So now the enemy's stockpiling a bunch of easy targets for my tigers to take out. Look at this. This entire division is stuck by conscripts. It's probably the most brilliant part of my planning here. And the tanks can't quite reach me, which is good. This is the point where I abandon this position. Once the artillery's here, the conscripts can't hold out anymore. One final blow, and then my tank can kill that. And now it's time to abandon the position. I put my defense plus 3 without artillery protection. The tigers are pretty scary. The enemy doesn't generally like screwing around. The Stug held it together. Perfect. The rough terrain has really slowed the enemy down, which allows me to evacuate in order. Thank you. Yep. I got a defense plus one on the 12.8. Not great. Once again, the Tigers are forming a wall of armor. Ran out of ammo on my 12.8. That's funny. With no fighters around, it's safe for the planes to do what they want. I had conscripts entrenched there. They were probably at maximum entrenchment at this point. And with no artillery support, I don't know how they were gonna crack them, but I decided to evacuate them right away. Wernsberger arrived. I actually held on to three. They never even got to this one. Seven entrenchment, seven. So the amount of damage I took was two on the 12.8. One on the Stug, one on the Tiger. That was unfortunate. And I think I took no damage on really most of it except for this. Oh, and I took two on this Stug. Most of the damage was bad luck except for this one. And this one was okay. So this is Cantanzaro. and the strategy of hold here until the artillery arrives, and then use the exit hexits to evacuate. And a Tiger and Wurmsburger are strong enough that by themselves they can keep retreating safely, and use your Air Force to protect everybody. And I brought all of my fighters, which is 4 plus 2 level bombers, plus Rudel, and that allowed me to do a lot, actually.